Welcome to the Acworth Leprosy Museum, a unique undertaking in India, which houses the displays related to the history of leprosy with the main focus on India. The museum comprises of two main parts. One is the history of the Acworth Municipal Hospital for Leprosy, originally known as the Homeless Leper Asylum, and the other is divided into 8 modules, each dealing with a historical facet of the disease. The asylum was established at Matunga in late 19th century in colonial Bombay, which prided itself as the first city of India. The city's cotton mills, the port, and the commercial wealth attracted job seekers as well as vagrants, including leprosy-affected beggars. The asylum was culmination of series of contemporary social, medical, and political developments. The death of Father Damien, the missionary who died of leprosy in Hawaii, which confirmed the worst fears of those who believed that leprosy was highly infectious. Secondly, growing importance of Bombay as a commercial and intellectual center. The absence of a formal or legal framework for dealing with the hordes of leper beggars who annoyed, disturbed and outraged well-to-do citizens, Europeans as well as Indians. A British official, Municipal Commissioner H.A. Acworth, who was so closely associated with its birth and early years that it was named after him in 1904 in acknowledgement of his significant role. The asylum was not only the place of confinement, but various medical treatments were tried over there. For example, chol mugra, nastin x-rays, gurgurn, etc. This physical barrier is direct evidence that there was a period when medical misconceptions ruled the interactions between the hospital staff and the patients. It was compulsory for doctors to use gloves and referral notes brought by outpatients before being touched by the staff. This questionable practice was discontinued in 1970s. Over the years, the inmates picked up various skills such as carpentry, electrician, tailoring, etc. The museum has preserved some examples of their skills. Our tour then takes us to displays pertaining to leprosy, the disease, timeline of developments in treatment, historic institutions for the leprosy affected, leprosy self-settled colonies and victims speak, literature and leprosy, archival records, reports and notices, leprosy under the legal gaze, and health education. There are also wax models on display from the collection of the Acworth Leprosy Hospital of deformities resulting from leprosy. Historically in India, victims of leprosy have borne the brunt of three manifestations of the law. They are traditional civil law, mainly dealing with marriage and inheritance of property; colonial penal code, dealing with suicide; and secular legislation on public health grounds, dealing with segregation and restrictions on civil liberties. It was not till the 1920s that the public was taken into confidence in state efforts to control leprosy. Most prominent were posters brought out under the auspices of Indian Council of British Empire Leprosy Relief Association and by other agencies after the independence. In the front gallery, there are three panels showing photographs and brief biographies of prominent leprosy workers in India and Europe, whose influence has been felt in small and large measure till the present. Lastly, the record room and library contains original documents and copies of social, medical, legal and institutional documents on leprosy in India, dating from 1860 till 1950. We close our tour with excerpts from the reminiscences of some inmates of the hospital.
అని ఏ టైంలో మంచి పరిస్థితి ఖరాబ్ అవుతారు ఇక్కడ అడ్మిషన్ వస్తూనే అవుతాయి బీమారీ సచ్చిలే ఇక్కడ ఇక్కడ ఇవాళ మా బాబా చెప్పి దోస్తుంది ఏమన్నా ఇక్కడ ఈ పను వాళ్ళే మళ్ళీ హాస్పిటల్ ఉంది ఇక్కడ అడ్మిషన్ చేస్తారు.